And so sit back in your tombs and enjoy the show. As you may have guessed, Lynn Hunting is not with us. She's on an extended vacation.
Didn't you get rid of the body?
I think so. Oh! I thought duct tape was a handyman's secret weapon. Go to credits or something, I don't know.
We can't. I lost my feather. We have lots of, time we have to still fill.
What's the next segment? It's alone. Yeah, he was alone. That's what killed him.
He died by being alone.
Yeah. It wasn't us.
It wasn't us. It was done by the good evil, the good Samaritans, Rudy and Stefan.
They're good. Quiet, you!
Shush! Anyway, like I said before, we have contests we have to go through. We have the contest regarding the watches given to us by J.M. Turner Goldsmith.
There's about eight of them, or four of them, or something?
Something like that. We have four guys
and we have
and
a mug
girls.
For you to win today. Whatever movies we mock, you can come down to the studio and
at the editing door.
Yep, and win.
Any two movies. So, up next, Alone.
By Rudy and Stefan.
Of these dogs when they retire from racing. Pat?
For the greyhounds.
Correct.
The ASPCA 600.
The ASPCA reminds you that you can lengthen a cat's neck.
When they operate the first ambulances. Pat, back here.
Based on All About Eve, it featured Lauren Bacall as Margot Channing.
Beth.
What is it, applause?
Yes. So long, dearie, to this musical, December 20th.
Well, welcome back.
Yeah, look at your costume.
There's nothing wrong with my costume. Yeah,
you look like a phantom, and you're a menace to society.
Oh, you're just so funny. Since when has death ever worn red?
Since now it's a fashion statement. Oh, well, what do we have next?
Fashion statement. Well, next we have this, well, a nice piece.
The Legal Witch Project.
The Legal Witch Project.
Took a whole 2 minutes to make.
Well, this was all shot last night. It was a very, very quick piece to do.
It was done by, I believe, me, Death, and Phantom, and the teacher, Mr. Bautestein.
Yep.
For the contest. For the end of it, you can come down to the studio, last segment, and... Oh, here we have the Legal Witch.
I'm so scared.
Is it a trap of some kind? I don't get it.
You're not supposed to, says Roger Ebert.
The infamous Legal Woods.
Who cares, proclaims Rolling Stone magazine.
Stupid trees.
You know, guys, it would really help if you took those cameras off your heads. Idiots.
Yes, they are, hails the Washington Post.
I think I found... I don't know what I found.
I'm getting so sick.
And so is the audience, declares Mark Horton of the Edmonton Journal.
I don't see it anymore.
Well, maybe you should hold the camera steady, states Ottawa Citizen.
Ow! Oh, that hurt.
It's all my fault. I forgot to bring extra tapes.
You did what?
Gotta go.
I say we just pack it in.
What's this red light flashing? Is that batteries?
Oh, that's me. Your battery's going too?
So what do you guys want to do tonight?
I don't know.
Want to go rent a movie or something like that?
Sure.
Yeah, sure. Let's go see ya. I'll leave it here. What do you guys want to watch?
I don't know.
Oh, I heard this new movie.
I hear The Exorcist.
It's really good.
I don't know.
Don't be a wuss.
Oh, well, I mentioned this before. We are having a contest today. All you have to do is mention one name of any movie that we've made fun of today, and you can
win. Okay, and you come down to the studio or whatever, and you can win, pow! One of these, a water bottle from A&W.
Plus,
anyway.
You also get put into the draw to win the watches. To do this, you have to come to the back editing room.
Yep.
Thank you.
Next up, we have Killer Tomatoes.
Small town of Morinville, Alberta, which is located north of Edmonton, was unexpectedly hit by vicious killer tomatoes this past week. Morinville Community High was hit the most.
The hallways that were once full are now almost empty. Many students that were seen walking around 1 minute are found dead the next. Teachers and students have mixed opinions about the attacks. I used to have friends. They all disappeared. Where is everyone?
Hi, we're speaking with Mr. Pritchard, and we're wondering how you felt about the attack of the killer tomatoes at MCHS.
I don't really have a problem with the attacks. I like tomatoes. We're both the same color, so I feel like a kindred spirit. So actually, the tomatoes in my mind are welcome around here any day of the week.
Okay, we are here with Esther, and we were just wondering how you felt about the attack of the killer tomatoes at MCHS.
This tomato is the reason we should bring capital punishment, is that what it's called, back to Canada, I think, yeah. So, die, tomato.
Homes in the surrounding area were hit as well.
Look at the giant tomato, Martha.
I didn't know they'd grow them so big, Jeff.
I wonder where he's going. He got little Timmy.
Poor Timmy.
Eat him all up.
When we asked why Morinville, the tomato said,
"Don't tell my superior, but we lost our mark. We landed in Morinville instead."
For now, this is Don Bullish reporting and warning all of you out there to be careful and watch your tomato crop. And watch out, because who knows when the killer tomatoes will hit your area next.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Whoa! Purple monkeys!
Purple monkeys?
Whoa, bad dream, sorry.
Okay. Oh,
Anyways, as we were saying before, what we want to do is you have the contest, you come to the back editing door, and if you're at home, you can come here.
You can email Mr. Bowdestein. I believe his email should be popping up on your screen right about now. Down there somewhere. And I think...
All contests must be in by at least 9 o'clock. Anything after 9 o'clock will be deleted and won't even be looked at.
Yeah.
But if...
You should have it in by 9 o'clock anyways.
Yeah, well, after you're out of school, yeah, of course. But,
You won't get this, but... Anyways, next up we have the volleyball piece.
It's by Jocelyn Bosseneau.
And she's no longer here. And enjoy.
It's a game kids love.
I just enjoy it. It's great. It's hard to let go. You get a love for the game and just gotta keep on playing until you can't play no more.
It's fun, it's challenging, and that's pretty good looking women play it, so it's just to fall into place. Get to play volleyball with the girls.
Well, it's always changing. To be honest, it's sort of like my philosophy about this game. If it ever stays the same, then you're really not improving. Approach, I guess, is part protective, in the sense that I don't want to experience something way too high or something way too low. And it's also, I'm using it as sort of a trial run for provincials.
Okay, it's not too late to learn a lesson. I will waste this entire tournament if it improves our chances of winning provincials.
Week before tournament's really an anxious week because everyone's getting all nervous about playing. And you're thinking about how you're going to do in front of school, and you've got this big team from Dallas coming in, and really, you just got to zone out.
Biggest tournament in Canada, so you have to be pumped up for it.
Everyone was real pumped.
not so much nervous, I guess, more jumpy and anxiety, and everybody was ready to go out and play, see what the teams would be like, see what our competition was, see if we were going to come together and play. It was the first real tournament of the game of the year that we actually had to step up, something that meant something to us.
I thought we bonded well as a team.
Dun 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 dun.
Dun, 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 dun.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event.
All of a sudden it chats out.
Push reset.
This seems like hot.
It's a technical difficulty.
Look like an inmate now.
Yes, folks, you can have this at home. The amazing Fleshmaster 3000. It's human flesh, but so easy. Just look at this satisfied customer.
We had a tough time this year playing morning games. Came a big tournament, we knew we had to step up for the morning game, and ended up We won our morning games that tournament, so it helped. Everybody started to get used to it, getting to a routine, getting up in the morning.
What are you doing here?
I'm making sweaters for the Western Canadian Challenge.
How many sweaters did you have to make?
As many as you can get done.
How many do you think you'll sell?
Pretty much all of them, and plus we'll get some orders. So we'll have to make some more.
How many in numbers?
I don't know.
You have no clue?
A couple hundred.
That's gone, I, know, I that's think. Yeah.
It was just, I looked at the orders, you finally.
Yeah, it'll happen. Like, oh. Alrighty.
So how many times does this machine break down through out making these shirts?
Too many.
A minute?
This one.
Depends on the day. Today is not a pretty day.
In there. Kind of hurts, doesn't it? It's a good way to send yourself to the hospital, too. 40 and 40.
Playing with the guys here in Morinville is great because everybody knows everybody else and you get to make fun of everybody else and they don't really mind, so.
Oh, it was great except for one guy, Jared Polanski. Got serious issues to deal with.
We joke around lots, but when it comes down to the crunch time, we're still able to put it all together and still play, put the game in front of everything else instead of joking around. And we had a pretty good idea of what everybody else was doing, what their roles were on the court, and what they were told to do, and believe that they do that.
The morning practices are vital. So we've been practicing at 7:20 regularly this week, just so the guys don't experience a little bit of sort of time shock, a little bit of sleeplessness. So they're a little more focused, because 7:20 is about when we're going to start our warm-up each morning. Then it improves our chances of being successful, and we don't have to, that's one less thing we have to worry about. So it's just a preparation factor mainly.
How many signs do you have to make for this tournament?
Oh, lots. 20 of these sizes with this stuff over here.
Right.
And we have like 96 of these to do.
Nice.
One for each team.
So how many hours have you spent on this?
So far about 20, if not more, and I'll be here like for a good 30 more hours at least.
Sir, did you guys get 3 points? You win 3 rounds, you guys get points. You guys get 5.
I'm a volleyball coach, but I think what I do best is I help people build themselves up, or I help build men. I'll teach you a lot of skills in terms of volleyball, but I try and at the same time teach you a lot of things about life. I believe in fairness, but I don't believe in equality. In other words, if everybody does get to play, but maybe not as much, then who's our chances of winning? What I mean by no jump practices, they are an active rest practice. They're a way for the kids to get their contacts in without jumping. I've got a belief that in life you only get so many jumps. In other words, your legs can only handle so much punishment, and it's just creatures. We're not really built for volleyball. So it's a way to get in there, think about volleyball, and not punish our bodies.
Okay, not bad. How do we feel?
Pretty good.
I'm going to probably be in the gym around, actually, we might be in the gym around noon, we'll see. But I don't want you guys to really mess around too much. No jumping if you're going to come to the gym today. Okay, don't be hitting any balls or anything like that.
Ready?
2-2-1, Wolves!
Nerves take over. I don't want to see anybody trying to be a hero out there. Sir, DeJuan needs to just make that kind of move. Could be either way. Don't give him a chance to scream that out, though. Okay, let's clear out here. Let's head down and warm up.
Boys!
Well, I was definitely excited and probably nervous, too. You know, I didn't think I was nervous till I was walking down into the gym with the couple hundred fans sitting there screaming. But, oh, definitely excited. I was looking forward to this. And I just went in there that weekend just to enjoy the experience. And it didn't matter what we did, really, as a team. You know, just go in and have fun and see what happens.
I was pumped up, I guess.
I wasn't really that excited. It's just another team from another place. It's not anything special. I felt we could have beat them.
Right from the start, a team effort means bench, you're up right from the start of the match. You're into this. You gotta be calling balls in and out of the short, long, where are they? Serving. We're gonna find a couple guys to block them.
You get off the bench just so you're off your. Just see you standing up and you're ready to get in the game.
You're not into the game, you're sitting down. If your coach asks you to step into the game, you're not meant to be prepared. You like you feel your position on the court.
Okay, now is going to be a good time to take all that stuff down to the gym.
All right. You
guys can all start
standing. I want a camera! I'm a camera boy, so I got to take my camera down.
Hey, fine. Are they hooked up?
Yes,
I'm working camera 3.
Since here's what's going to happen, cameras, remember, director as well. When we're doing our play, when the ball's in play, we're on camera 2. Avoid the temptation to go to camera 1 or camera 3 until the play is whistled or, you know, called, you know, stopped. At that point, camera 1 and 3, you're responsible for reaction on your side. Let's get down there. Let's do it.
Come on.
McNally Tigers. Now, here's what we want to do for
this. Step by camera 1, take camera 1. Step by camera 2, take camera 2.
That's an easy way to identify our teams using titles.
Big game, gentlemen. Okay, let's see what kind of money players we got on this team. Win this, you're guaranteed to move on. Either second or third, guaranteed, no questions asked. Okay? Anything else, you leave it in somebody else's hand to decide. Let's not do that.
got to work on your quickness, you got to work on your mental speed and your physical speed, your vertical jumping ability, stuff like that. You just got to be able to be an all-around good player.
All of us are pretty hard on each other, push each other as much as we can when people aren't doing their job and they hear about it, but we stay pretty positive. And
first or 25th? We all want first.
But we have the momentum. Okay? Let's go out and play. We're on the good side. We're going to serve a little more aggressive on this side. Okay, we're going to go after him. We start this way, this game. Let's go after him.
Ready? 3-2-1, Wolves!
Hey, Daryl, you got to talk. That's your man coming around. I haven't heard you say a word. If it's a 52, you help him in that block. If he comes around, you better scream for it.
I kept us going. We knew after the game he wasn't going to hold it against us. He loves the game. He can't help it. It's just the way he coaches. Everybody got along with Skaggs here. We all love him. The guy played his heart out on the bench just as hard as we did on the floor, and it's just emotions that come out. You can't stop them.
All right? They run another 52, and we only got one man up. I'm going to start crying. Okay? Get 2-3 men on that 52. Gentlemen, all we need is one side up. We got no problem. Let's go.
Ready? 3-2-1, Wolves!
You got to give me a break once. You got to give me something this match. You haven't given me anything yet.
I thought we did respectable, you know. I mean, it's too bad we didn't win a couple more games, get a little further in the playoffs, but I thought we bonded well as a team, and still it's only a tournament. Our goal was to win provincials, which we didn't do, but we did pretty good in that too. So I think the tournament was fine, you know.
Okay. Remember, this weekend is the WCC, the Western Canadian Challenge.
And there's a dance going on Wednesday too, isn't there?
Wednesday night, there's the dance, and then all weekend, we're going to be working. But the last 3 hours of Saturday night, we're actually going to be broadcasting.
Yep. Anyways, we have a winner, don't we?
Yes, we have a winner. Chris Triff.
Yeah.
Well, tell us what was our wonderful
answer.
The answer is Blair Witch Project.
Very good,
actually,
very good.
That's correct. And what do you get for that? You get water bottle.
And your name is entered
to win one of these beautiful watches. I believe there's guys and girls.
Yep.
How many of them are there? We're giving them away in December.
Yes, later on in December after we've had enough applicants.
It's like Christmas and all that. And
anyway, thank you very much.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Okay, we had, sort of a good show.
It was a good show. I think it was a good
show.
Yeah,
okay.
Being the Halloween special on. Us two wonderful hosts, you know, the Phantom and Death.
Yeah, Death is pretty cool.
Death is okay, I guess. But
I get to kill people.
We have to hope for the best and make sure the next show is even better than this one.
Yep. So stay tuned for, not stay tuned, but
for the Remembrance Day show on November 2nd.
Canadian Challenge and all that stuff coming up.
See you next time.
Hi, my name is
what?
My name is My name is
His name's Sadie.
Hi. My name is
huh?
My name is
what?
My name is
His name's Sadie.
Hi. My name is
what?
Excuse me. My name is
His name's Sadie.
Can I have the attention of the class for 1 second? My name is
His name's Sadie.
Hi kids, do you like Primus?
Yeah,
wanna
yeah.
see me stick 9-inch nails to each one of my eyelids?
Uh-huh.
Wanna copy me and do exactly like I did? Try sit and get messed up worse than my life is? My brain's dead weight. I'm trying to get my head straight, but I can't figure out which Spice Girl I want to impregnate. And Dr. Dre said,
Slim Shady, you a basic. Why's your face red? Man, you wasted.
Well, since age 12, I felt like a caged elf who stayed to himself in one space chasing his tail. Got ticked off and ripped Pamela Lee's lips off. Kissed him and said, I ain't no silicone, was supposed to be this soft. I'm about to pass out and crash and fall in the grass faster than a fat man who sat down too fast. Come here, lady.
Shady, wait a minute. That's my girl, dawg.
I don't give a damn. Dre sent me to take the world off.
Hi, my name is
what?
My name.